Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the main event of the evening. Are you ready?
Well, my next guest, his father perfected Jiu Jitsu and it became Gracie Jiu Jitsu or Brazilian Jiu Jitsu. So my next guest needs no introduction. It is an absolute honor to have you here, Royler Gracie. Thank you so much. I appreciate you.
Well, it's good having you. It's my pleasure to be with you, and I hope you're not going to choke me.
Not me. I'm here to learn from you.
There you go.
Yeah, you've been teaching your family's jiu-jitsu for a long time. You know, it must be really wonderful to see how many lives you've changed.
It's not even my life, it's still changing, you know. Yeah. Every day I'm thinking about this. Yeah, jiu-jitsu, it's unbelievable. It's a mass, you know, transformation in a lot of people. And for the kids, it's unbelievable. Oh. It's more than ever, you know. I'd see myself, you know, as a little kid, like a 7 years old, and then start training jiu-jitsu with 3 years old. The time I got 7, 8, I already trained jiu-jitsu for a long time, yeah. You know, 5 years already, 4 years. And you think you're the man, yeah. You know. I actually have a history between me and Royce one time. We just walked back from the school, like around 9 and 10 years old. And 9, 10 years old, I'm already training jiu-jitsu for 7 years.
Wow.
It's a long time. Yeah. And one boy tried to rubber us something, you know, and I look at Roy and say, he tried to rubber us? And Roy say, I think so. And then I run into the boy running, Roy say, let him go, Roy, come on, you know. But, you know, so much confidence, you know, so
sure.
Makes you so strong and open your mind for a lot of different things. You know, it's not only to be a fighter, but it's all, a lot of decisions in your life.
Absolutely.
It's unbelievable.
It gives you confidence
a
to
lot.
Be yourself.
Yep.
And not worry about, you know, people
yeah.
who want to bully you or,
right.
you know, push you around. It's absolutely fantastic.
Yeah.
I feel it in my life, and it's changed my life as well.
Yeah, yeah. I'm glad my uncle Carlos and my father Helio have the vision, you know, the time they start training, and they put everything together and make it better and better, and make the people's be here not only to learn as a martial art, but as a friendship.
Oh,
and
yes.
That's make a big difference, you
that's
know,
a huge
because
difference.
It's in back in time. If you see every time you come, you need to kind of bounce and then I'm scared with the teacher. We don't have this, you know, for actually one thing my father say all the time, for you to be my student, you need to be my friend first.
Sure.
You know, and that's amazing. It's changed
yes.
it completely. Yeah.
Yeah. It opens you up emotionally.
Yep.
So you can connect on a different level. And the learning process is quicker and easier.
Right.
Yes, it's fantastic. Now, you know, I know you've been teaching jiu-jitsu for a long time, and you've seen so many students come and go, but you've also seen transformations. So jiu-jitsu changes lives. Would you agree?
I agree 100%. That's all about, you know.
Mm-hmm.
It's making you more strong, more health,
oh.
you know, more confident. You know, it's everything, you know, you make a decision. Sometimes you look forward and then you never look back anymore. You know, you think like, you know, that's a normal life, but I think it's the whole martial arts give it to you this, but we're talking about jiu-jitsu because that's what I've been involved my whole life.
Sure.
And jiu-jitsu for sure give you a lot of confidence. That's 100%.
Yes.
Yeah.
It is. It's incredible. You know, you growing up down there in Brazil, that is fascinating. You growing up in your household with so many jiu-jitsu, not only students, but brothers and sisters. You got a story for us from Grandmaster Helio with all of you down there?
You know, it's my father's not the one to kind of push us to train jiu-jitsu.
Sure.
He just tried to motivate. It's a different, you know. It's one of the stories I'm always talking about is one time we are kids, we go to the tournament, and then he put everybody together and say, hey, whatever win, I give it $20. And whatever who lose, I give you $40. And then we look at each other and say, well, we're gonna give more money for someone lose. And that's the kind of, he look at us and say, yeah. And by the way, that day I lose, but I got more money than my
yeah.
brothers and cousins. And that's one thing keep me motivated to train and be there, you know. It's a very hard for the kid, the time they lose, they come back to the school and
sure.
feel shine, feel bad. And that's my father always, they put us in the situation is you don't need to prove nothing. you were gonna be the same, sure. You know? And then we treat everybody's the same, not even if you're a champion, if you're not a champion. And that's one thing I really like from my father and how I grow up and make me feel myself much more comfortable. You know, it's unbelievable. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. It is absolutely unbelievable.
Yeah.
I went through an experience not too long ago where I almost died, and it was health related. And I had to come back to jiu-jitsu because of it. It was either jiu-jitsu or I was really in big, deep trouble.
Right.
And it's really changed me. I got to hand it to you guys.
That's
who,
good.
Who perfected this? You know, your father and you and Hoyce and your brothers. I'm so thankful. So thankful. It's changed my life. So, you know, the regular street person out there, regular citizen out there, you know, if they have an interest in Gracie Jiu Jitsu, you know, is there any prerequisites to come in and train? Is there any reason at all to ever feel intimidated? I would say no, from my own experience. But we want to hear from Master Royler.
It's no intimidate, you know, it's a martial art. Sure. But you're here to learn how to defend yourself. Sure. And that's what we used to say. We're not trying to push the people to be a world champion. And my father actually say this to us all the time. You know, I'm not preparing you guys to be a world champion, to be a fighter. I'm preparing you guys to know how to defend yourself. And that's amazing, you know. Yes. It's a completely different. If you try to be a champion, well, it's going to be a plus. It's, of course, everyone like to have the medal, to be a champion, not even for the kid. But I prefer myself than be a champion. Make sure I know how to protect myself.
Yes.
Don't get slapped in the face.
Sure.
You know, if you're a little boy, you got slapped in the face, you don't know how to block yourself. And that's one thing my father always say, hey, I pay a lot of money. Make sure you protect yourself. You know how to protect yourself. The medals is going to be in the wall one day.
Yeah.
And the people forget the medals. That's all about.
So it's going to be inside you forever.
Yep.
You'll know it, and
yep. You'll
feel secure with it.
Yep.
What are the keys to being successful with Gracie Jiu Jitsu?
Well, if I go back on time and see my father, the first thing to be a success, the relationship, the teacher with the student. Well, my father is always my teacher. My brother is my teacher. And the relationship they have between me and my father, and me and my brothers and my cousin, it's amazing. They don't treat you like a student. Sure. They don't put you under the foot, you know. Yeah. They always put you up and make you looking good. And then I think this is the best, that's the success for any academy. If the teacher needs to treat you like a part of the team, yeah. You know. And that's one of the most valuable thing I saw. And then I learned from my father. Well, it's in my opinion, is learning Gracie Jiu Jitsu is make you learn how to defend yourself. But not only defend yourself, in my opinion, is one of the best methodology is self-defense in the world, you know. And then we proved this the long time we already be there. And it's smooth, easy, and simple. And that's actually, that's one of my uncle Carlos and my father, they do all life, you know. It's make everything so smooth, you know. And like I say, like all the time what they say, you know, every time you step in the match, make sure you're happy.
Sure.
And then you like to be here, you enjoy to be here.
Professor, what do you think the most difficult part about your jiu-jitsu journey has been in your life?
Well, for me, pretty smooth, you know. It's hard to ask you because I always have the support and help of the family.
Sure.
The family always help me. But I think for the beginner students is the more hard part, is the white to the blue and blue to the purple.
Yeah.
And most of the people, before they got the blue or before they got the purple belt, they say, they give up, you know. And that's the deal. Don't give up. Enjoy what you have, you know, and then for sure you're gonna get there. It's a patient, you know. Sometimes you think you don't lose, but it's a part to improve.
Sure.
You know, and that happened with me is back in time, you know, it's a long ago. I'm a blue belt, and then I talked to my brother, say, I can do the position. He looked at me like, say, hey, calm down, you're gonna get there, you're gonna got your time. And then you're right, you know, it's a timing, you know, process. Just enjoy.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Patience and perseverance.
Yep.
Absolutely. Professor, What do you think, in your opinion, makes Gracie Jiu Jitsu so addictive and fun for people like me that come in and people in our academies at Gracie Umaita?
Well, like we talked before, mm-hmm. it's my opinion, is how my uncle and my father, they put everything together. You know, for us, is the experiences. For you to be my student, you need to be my friend first.
Sure.
And that's the main thing, you know. You're not gonna treat you like one more. We treat you like a friend. And that's just, you know, shake hands, hang each other. And that's a different culture, you know. We try to make more close each other. And I think this is the big difference, you know. And that's the success. That's the key for the success is a Gracie Jiu-Jitsu, you know. And of course, is the program we have, the self-defense, the competition, and MMA, we kind of involve in everything, you know?
Yes. You know, we're going to have BJJ guys out there watching this, you know, really glued in on this because your answers really spark, you know, desire and knowledge in them to want to do better. Say, like, a new guy wants to compete in a BJJ competition. Would you have any advice for him or me? Because I want to, you know, compete in BJJ.
Well, the best advice for someone like to compete, first of all, of course, you need to find a good place training.
Sure.
You know, they have the access to the best technique. You know, maybe you need to take a breakfast, lunch, and dinner training jiu-jitsu. And not even between the meals, you're still talking about jiu-jitsu. And that's going to be the full-time job, you know, if you like to be a champion, if you like to compete, if you like to have a success. But competition is not everything.
Sure.
You know, like we talked before, the medal one day is going to be in the wall. And it's, you know, someone slap you in the face, you don't know how to defend yourself. And then it's jiu-jitsu is more than competition. You right. know, I love to compete. And then I myself compete a lot my whole life. And then I enjoy to watch the boys today. They're so fast, they're so good, they're so amazing how they do the position. You know, the guys in my class, in the class below, they're so fast, and not even the open division. They're so good. But we need to think about, you know, what you're looking for to be as a champion is a kind of little different training. And then, of course, jiu-jitsu is everything, is one bag. Is make sure if you're a champion, you learn the self-defense too.
Sure.
And then if you learn the self-defense, you make sure you learn the competition
yeah.
in the same way. You'll be able to train, enjoy the academy, enjoy the training. You're not going to be side and watch someone compete and I'm not going to be able to train or only have to do the self-defense. I never do the self-defense only in my life. Jiu-jitsu for me, it's a training, sparring, and self-defense, everything in the same bag.
Yeah, it's interesting
yep.
because it becomes your life once
right.
you really commit to it.
Yep.
And it takes a huge commitment. It changes lives.
It's one of the amazing examples I have, you know, and says it back in time, you know, as my father watched me train and then he looked at me and said, hey, I saw you like to compete and then I'm so happy, you know. I say, yes, I love to compete. And he say, be careful. And then I said, why be careful? Because every time you start thinking too much about the competition, you leave your face for your opponent to throw a punch. And then I'm just kind of, whoa, I don't even thinking about this. You know, it's amazing how he say, because you're more relaxed. He's a point system. And then he say, just be careful. Competition is amazing, but it changes completely what exactly you're looking for. If you fight in the street, you need to block yourself. If you compete, it's by a point, by the advantage, you know? And you can have the same, everything in the same bag, but we need to separate a little bit. If you start to compete too much, you forget the real life, you know? And that's what we're here for, to train yourself for the real life. Too.
Yes,
both, you know, if you like to get a medal, it's a different, but if you like to be training for yourself, for self-defense, you're not a competitor anymore, is make sure, thinking about, yeah.
Well, my name is Jameson Sharp, and I'm sitting here with Master Royler Gracie, or Professor Royler Gracie. I really appreciate you coming on, and...
Well, I can say something, you
sure.
know, I think it's one of the best things if you're looking for some academy, Gracie Academy or Jiu-Jitsu Academy, try to check the program, what they have. You know, if
sure.
they follow the program, if how they treat the student, not even the kids class, you know. We have amazing school in Kansas. It's a Kansas City. You can go to Instagram. It's at Gracie Maita KC. And then we have the Gracie Maita in Kansas City with Professor Mike. It's unbelievable teacher, you know. And make sure you guys double check over there.
Yes, we'd love to have you. Just please come on in. Please sign up online and check us out online. We're on all the social media platforms, and we would love to have you. Professor, thank you so much. It's a true honor to actually sit down and interview you.
My pleasure.
And spend some time with you again. And until next time, thanks for joining us. My name is Jameson Sharp, and this is
Royler Gracie. Thank you.
And that's all we got for today. And we'll see you guys next time. Thank you so much. Thank you.